Great. The sound did finally come up on the first part of this module. So again, I'm going to record this. This is the third time I'm trying to record the second half. But we'll go ahead and finish up module 39 and then we can move on to module 40. So this topic is translating the graph of a logarithmic function. It says below is the graph of y equals log base 2 of x, and that's this graph here in blue. Now, originally, they're only going to give you that point there. And then the curve. That's all they give you. Okay? It says translate it to become the graph of log base 2 x plus 1 plus 4. Okay? Now, if this is a grab and slide kind of problem in ALEKS, then all you need to do is grab that one point and move this around whichever way you need to, and move your asymptote around if you need to. And that's it. However, if this wasn't just a translation problem, they just wanted you to graph this all on its own, this is a method that I'm going over. Okay? So I'm going to go over first just the shortcut way to do it if you're just asked to translate it by grabbing points and moving them around. However, if it's asking you to graph the asymptote, graph a couple of points, and then click the graphing icon, then it's a little bit more difficult to graph. Okay, so for here, notice that this is going to make it move to the left 1 unit because it's inside the parentheses. This 4 is outside the parentheses, so that's going to make it go up 4 units. Now, you do have an asymptote when it comes to logarithms. It is a vertical asymptote. Normally, that vertical asymptote is on top of the y-axis. So normally, the vertical asymptote is right here. But if you have to move it up or down, it's not really going to change a vertical asymptote. It's going to shift it up, but this thing is going on forever and ever. So when you shift it up, it's still going on forever and ever up and down. It's when you go left or right that the asymptote is going to move. So that means if I'm moving this to the left 1 unit, I also need to move the vertical asymptote 1 unit. So I'm going to grab that vertical asymptote and I'm going to slide it over 1 unit. I'm also going to grab that one point that they gave me right here, and I'm going to slide it to the left 1 unit and then up 4 units. And so now it becomes this point right here on top of the y-axis. And then it should graph it fine if that's how Alex expects you to graph it. But if Alex wants you more than just to drag and drop, and you actually need to plot points, then this is where this is going to come in handy. Okay? We cannot type in, I cannot make a chart with X's and Y values, pick a bunch of X's and plug them into that equation. And the reason I can't do that is because I have base 2. And you can't type base 2 in your calculator. Okay? So what I need to do is I need to convert this into an exponential problem. So notice that my base is 2, so my base became 2. And also, I'm not translating this one actually. I'm translating the parent function. Okay? So this one's got shifts in it. I don't want the one with shifts in it. I want the just basic one, which is this one here, which is why I boxed it. Okay? I will do the shifting and all of that, but for right now, we just need the original. So log base 2. So 2 is my base, that's where it is. And remember, a logarithmic is equal to the exponent. So y is going to become my exponent. And then my argument is going to become the answer on this side. Or you can use that same kind of cheat sheet rule that I showed you, right? Where the base stays the same and the other two numbers switch sides. So the x will be alone on one side and the y should be connected to the 2. And that's exactly what we have here. Now, I still can't plug in x values, right? That won't help me figure out what y is. But I can plug in y values and then just do the exponential part and come up with the x's. So the two numbers that I used are negative 1, 0, and 1. And as I was working in ALEKS, I found out I don't even need to do the negative 1 because it always just asks you to graph 2 points. So really, you only need to plug in 0 for y and 1 for y. Now, if I plug in 0 as my exponent, any base to the exponent of 0 is going to be 1. And then if I plug in 1, any base to the exponent of 1 is just going to be that base. So those are my two points here. So I have 1, 0, which is the point they gave me. And then I have 2, 1, which is this point here. And then if I want to shift, what's going to happen to these points? Right? If I want to shift to the left 1 unit, that means I'm going to have to minus 1 from my x values. And if I want to go up 4 units, that means I'm going to have to add 4 to my y values. So my new points become 0 and 4. And then here becomes 1 and 5. And that's the exact points that we have here. So 0 and 4, 1 and 5. So if I were to have to graph this without just grabbing one graph and shifting it over like a drag and drop, if I actually have to physically graph it, all you need to do is make sure you move your vertical asymptote over. So graph the vertical asymptote at negative 1 instead of at 0. And then graph the two points you have here. And then click on the graphing icon. So the same thing for this problem here. It's got the same directions, except the function that they give me is different, right? So, and normally it says graph the asymptote and then plot two points. So here, again, I cannot translate this into the exponential. I have to translate the original, right, before the shifts. So the original before the shifts was just log base 2 of x. So this is what I've transferred over into exponential form. Base is 2, x and y switch sides. And then I could plug in numbers for y, like 0 and 1, because those are easy. And when I plug in 0 for the exponent, I get 1. When I plug in 1 for the exponent, I get 2. Now, I plot these two points, but those would be the original graph. Okay, I don't want that. What I need to do is I need to move to the right 1 unit, and the number on the outside tells me I need to go down 3 units. So if I need to go to the right 1 unit, that means I'm going to add 1 to my x values to make them go to the right. And then if I want to move down, I'm going to have to minus 3 to my y values. So my new points become 2 and negative 3, and 3 and negative 2. So 2 and negative 3, and then 3 and negative 2. That's these two points right here. Only thing left you need is the asymptote. And since it did go to the right 1 unit, the asymptote should be on top of the y-axis, but we're going to graph it over to the right 1 unit. So once you have your asymptote and you have your two points right here, you don't need a third. Just if you have these two points right there and you click the graphing icon, it should draw the curve for you. So as anticipated, they're going to ask us to do that without giving us the telling us to translate it. Okay, so here they want us to graph this. And so what I've done is I've taken that function, instead of using the fancy notation of x, we just use y, and then we swapped the forms over. So the base is 1/3, the x and y switch sides, and then I typed in 0 and 1 for the exponent. Any base to the exponent of 0 will equal 1, and any base to the exponent of 1 will just be that base. So I have 1/3 here. And then the asymptote, notice that there's no left or right shifting, right? No left or right shifting, which means the vertical asymptote stays on y-axis. Okay, so notice I graphed my vertical asymptote on the y-axis, and then I plotted these two points, 1/0, 1/3, 1. You may need to use that button that allows you to type in the coordinates so that it could plot this point for you, because there is a fraction. Okay, but once you have your asymptote and your two points, hit the graphing icon and it will draw the curve for you. Here, this one does have some shifting going on, but I rewrote this. Okay, I like to write the log in the front and then the constants in the back. So this function can be rewritten like this. Now, what is the parent function before all the shifting, right? The parent function is just the logarithmic part, without any shifts on the inside here and without any shifts on the outside, okay? And if I change the fancy notation g of x to just y, I can swap this over into its exponential form. And then do the same thing. Plug in 0 for y, I just get 1. Plug in 1 for y, and I get 2 for x. Now, again, the same thing here. There's nothing inside the parentheses there. So if there's nothing inside the parentheses there, that means my vertical asymptote stays on the y-axis. So there's my my asymptote on top of the y-axis. However, I do have to shift these basic points down 3 units. So to do that, I need to minus 3 to my y-values, which means that this is going to become 1 and negative 3. And this is going to become 2 and negative 2. So this here is the basic graph. That is not my answer. And I was not asked to graph the basic graph. I was asked to graph the final answer, right? So I get 1 and negative 3. And then I get 2 and negative 2. And if you hit the graphing icon, it should graph this for you. Okay, one last topic. So here it says graph, domain, and range of a logarithmic function. So the graph is the same situation. It's the domain and range that's new here. So again, before any shifts, what was the parent function? The parent function was just log base 2 of x. If I switch the forms over, I get this. And if I plug in 0 and 1 for the exponents, I get this. So remember, these are the basic points to the basic function, okay? So I'm going to erase this because that's not the answer. Then you have to take into consideration, is there a left or right shift? There is, because I have plus 1 inside the parentheses. It means I do need to go left 1 unit, which means that the vertical asymptote is not going to be on the y-axis anymore. It's going to be shifted over 1 unit. But that also means that my parent function or my basic points are also going to have to shift to the left 1 unit. And to shift something to the left, you have to minus 1 from the x-axis. So that means this is going to become 0, 0, and this is going to become 1, 1. So my points here should be 0, 0, and then 1, 1. And if you draw the graphing button on your computer in Alex, it will draw the function for you. Now, once you have the graph, you should be able to determine the domain and the range. Domain is the set of x values and range is a set of y values. So if I imagine that this whole bar here translates down to the x-axis, I have this shaded. And if I imagine all of this translated down to the x-axis, I have all of that shaded with an arrow, right? How do you put that into notation? It's going to be from this x value, which is negative 1, on to the right forever, which is infinity. We know infinity always gets parentheses, but what happens here at negative 1? Because I have an asymptote there, I will never ever actually touch negative 1, which means it has to be a parentheses. Now the same thing with the range. If I imagine that this lower part of the graph translates onto the y-axis, it will look like this with an arrow. And if I imagine this part transferring on, like lying down flat onto the y-axis, it will look like this, but again with an arrow. Okay, so what is that? If I go from the lowest value, it does have an arrow, which means it goes downward to negative infinity, all the way to the top, and looks like it goes upward to positive infinity, and there is a point there. So, and we know infinities always get parentheses here. So that's the domain and range for this particular graph, okay? just imagine the graph flattening onto the x-axis, and whatever that bar graph is, that's your domain. And then imagine the graph flattening onto the y-axis, and whatever that number line looks like as an interval, that's the range. Okay, now what happens if we don't have a graph, or if there's something inside the parentheses that we can't transform? Okay, how do we determine the domain? The biggest thing to remember is that when you have a logarithmic equation, the base and the argument must be positive. Now here the base is not given, so we assume that it is 10, and 10 is a positive base. So we're good as far as the base being positive. What we also have to ensure is that the argument is positive. So we took that argument 9 minus 2x and made it greater than 0 to ensure that it is positive. Then we minus 9 on both sides, and then we divide by negative 2 on both sides. Excuse me. Now remember, when you divide by a negative while solving an inequality, you must flip the inequality symbol over. If you divide by a negative, you must flip the inequality symbol over. So a negative divided by a negative ends up becoming positive 9/2, but because I divided by a negative, this symbol had to flip over. So if I draw this on a number line, it would mean 9/2 with an open dot because there's no bar, and then x is less than this number. So I would shade everything to the left of that number. And how do I write that in interval notation? It goes forever to the left, so negative infinity to 9/2 here. Now, infinity always gets parentheses. This is a whole, so it should also get parentheses.